What is up YouTube, Luca here with another PvP build, this time with a dual-wield stamina warden setup. Big thanks to my mate Jonas for this unusual build. What makes this unusual? Well, look at this set, vicious death on a stamina warden. Yep, it works and it's OP as fuck, especially with this juicy mythic item, the mana cut ring. It buffs also vicious death by 16%. It's ridiculous, guys. How can be a Magicka set so strong on a stamina warden? Well, Zoss logic. Our second set is Armor Master on the back bar, just to gain extra tankiness. But if you prefer a full damage setup, you could even go for Clever Alchemist here or Powerful Sword on the back bar. As monster set, what else? Barlog and one trainee chest in heavy. 5 medium, 1 light, 1 heavy, full infused on jewelry, and 2 vicious death swords. 2 maces would be even better, but I already had 2 swords from a Magicka bomb blade. On the back bar, sword and board. Traits, 5 impen, 2 well fitted, full infused weapon damage on the jewelry. On the front bar, a near main hand and sharpened offhand, and on the back bar a powered sword and a sturdy shield. Glyphs, full prismatic on the body, then full weapon damage on the jewelry. On the main hand weapon a berserker glyph for extra weapon damage, on offhand a disease glyph, and on the back bar the stamina drain poisons. Quick look on the skills. Cutting Dive, a powerful single target, spammable. It also sets the enemy off balance, and it deals good amount of bleed damage too. Then Sub Assault, our AoE burst skill, try to use it before you ulti dump. Then Whirling Blades, our AoE spammable. Bird of Prey, which gives Mage Expedition, so 30% extra movement speed. And Minor Berserk, another 5% more flat damage. Shooting Spores, our stamina AoE heal. Alternative, you could go for Arctic Blast, but I prefer the Spores instead, since we need the Magicka for other skills like Bird of Prey, Shimmering, and our resistance buff. As ultimate, of course, Dombeck of Smiting. Alternative, you could go for Permafrost. On the back bar, Shimmering Shield. One of the strongest defensive skills out there, use it guys. It absorbs projectiles and it gives major heroism, super strong. Our Bull Nudge for sustain and major brutality, resolving vigor, our hot, ice fortress, our resistance buff, and it gives minor protection too, 5% damage reduction. Then shuffle for major evasion, so 20% less AoE damage, and it's our snare removal too. Backbar ultimate, defensive ultimate, spell wall. Alternative, you could go for healing thicket, not so pretty strong. As race, I am not for the extra resistance. Imperial or Orc are fine too. As Mundostone, the serpent for sustain. As buff food, the llama food soup. Since HP region is nerfed by 50%, we can go for this food instead of the Arteum takeaway broth. But we have to put a lot of points in health. I have 34 points here and 30 in stamina. As potions, the classic physical resistance potions with stamina and health. Sometimes I use the tricep potions too for extra magicka regen, or before I ulti dump, this immovability potions with mage expedition, stamina and CC immunity. Quick look on the CPs. Master at Arms, Biting Aura, Resilience, Duelist Rebuff, Red Ones, Rejuvenation, Slippery, Juggernaut, and Ironclad. Now I will show you the common PvP combo. It's pretty easy and effective. Start always with Sub Assault, then 2 Cliff Razors, into Dawnbreaker, into Whirling Blades. That's all. If you kill an enemy, Vicious Death gets procced and the targets will melt. That's the end of another PvP build video. check out the gameplay footage with this setup. I will link it in the description below. If you like my content, sub my channel, leave likes and comments, share my videos. I would really appreciate it, guys. Next build will be probably a Stamina Templar. Big thanks for the support, guys. I wish you all a fantastic day, and I see you hopefully in the next video.